Okay, we're going to solve this inequality because here we have a greater than symbol. So this is an inequality. And as we can see, we have the m on both sides. Likewise, we have the numbers on both sides, right? As a good habit, we should be consistent. Let's go ahead and move the variables from the right to left. And then move the number from the left to the right. With that being said, here we have negative m. I'm just going to add the m on both sides so that this and that will be canceled it, and we can just have all the m on the left-hand side. So once again, I add the n on both sides. And in the meantime, this is a positive 2. So let's go ahead and minus 2 on both sides, like this and like that. So they'll be canceled it. Do this carefully though. Here we have negative 4m plus, this is technically a 1, right? Plus 1m. Combine these two numbers, negative 4 plus 1 is negative 3, right? So we have negative 3, but that's the m term, so we have negative 3m on the left-hand side. And since we didn't multiply, we didn't divide any negative number, the symbol greater than stays the same, like this. And now, here we have the positive 17 minus 2. Work that out, we get 15. And we see that this is negative 3 times m is greater than 15. How can we get the m by itself? This is negative 3 times m, right? We have to divide both sides by negative 3. I will also divide this by negative 3, so that you see this and that will be canceled it. Finally, we see the m on the left-hand side by itself. Work this out, 15 over negative 3, we end up with negative 5. But we divide both sides by a negative number. This is a negative 3. So be sure you take this inequality and you switch direction. Instead of opening this way, it becomes opening this way. Instead of greater than, now it becomes less than. So, as you can see, final answer, m is less than negative 5. That's it.